And welcome, 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 ladies and gentlemen, to a new series on the Michaela Lobstronesis channel called, and today, What If is, what if the 1998 World Championships happened? Only on Michaela Lobstronesis. So in this scenario, we are going to do, what if in 1998, they did a full world championships. They did a team, all around, an event final world championships like normal in 1998 instead of 1997. What if they did an individual world championships in 1997 and did the normal world championships in 1998, kind of like the format they do now. Now we have to understand under that code of points, in the team finals, because that's what we're talking about specifically in this video, but we will continue the 1998 seasons in this series. In this particular video, we must understand that it was a six-person team, five members went up, four scores count. That happened in... So if I did make it clear before, there are six members to a team. Five members of that team go up on each event. Four scores from that five persons on each event count. You do the same thing in qualifications and team finals. There was no three up three count, so we can't use that format. We're using the 6-5-4 format for this video. So in this scenario, the team is Vanessa Atla, Kristen Maloney, Dominique Mucciano, Jenny Thompson, Kim Zemesko, and Elise Ray. And the alternate is Jamie Danger. I chose to use Kim Zemesko over Jamie Danger for the actual team because going back to her 1998 national championships, she actually did have scores Team USA needed at that time. Again, and we're also saying that this team finals, I'm not counting falls. I'm doing a fall-free world championship team. That's why I got the team final score that I got, which we will discuss later on at the end of the video.
Teammate Shannon Miller didn't work out. Well, you know, Mary Lee said that she realizes a lot of people thought she was washed up after 1996, and she said Jenny's really doing gymnastics for herself today.
Much more difficult ball. One and a half twist.
All right.
A lot of power, but a big hop on the limb. Let's see how she does here. Actually, what she injured her leg on, the landing is critical. It's a blind one. Tremendous. Hamstring laid out front of the half twist.
That was beautiful.
Vanessa to overtake her top spot, so she wants to just hold on a second and get the serve.
Well, that shouldn't be a problem whatsoever. She loves this event. It should be very easy.
Very difficult.
Problems in the preliminary round started right here, right on the mount.
In the first day of competition, right on the mount. Looks good so far.
After the skill right here, this was the first problem. The other evening, she's on.
More release right here. Got it.
You get the feeling everyone in the arena knows of her past problems. To stand out. There always seemed to be someone else on the team that was the focus, but now she's got to be it.
Last year, this was her weakest event here at the national championships. This year, it's one of her strongest. In fact, she has two moves named after her. The first one coming up right here. That's the Maloney one.
And this is the Maloney 2 right here. First release coming right here. Coach Jack Carter. She's standing by. Completely revamped uneven bars. Struggled at first. Changed the routine around. New dismount.
Here with Aminar and Horkina. Mociano mounts the bar.
Now she's added a couple new elements or combinations right here out of her Pax Alto X. Oh, oh no. Good cover.
Oh, she was over. Nice move.
Still managed to keep form as she saved the element. We'll see what the judges do. And her dismount is new. So watch closely as she prepares for it. She's going to add a combination. It's very tricky. She's got to be right on. Here she twists into it, right into the double front. Year after the world championships in 97, she had shoulder surgery for a torn rotator cuff. Then in February, in her comeback, she had a torn right calf muscle. She just won this qualifier prior to coming to the national championships, so she's back on track. Push out. Olympian Dominique Dawes. This is her first year as a senior competitive. She's wonderful on this event. What makes her so unique is her form and her great swing.
Competition 1992, the Olympic Games, but it was here in Indy in 1991. She was the world all-around champion.
So good memories might be flooding back, although the competition was not held here. It was held at the RCA Dome.
She says actually her best gymnastics
ever.
Thank you.
Well, and up. Good job.
Mary Lee Tracy in the background. She's coaching Kim Zanesco now. She says it's an honor, and not much has really changed. She remembered Kim as an athlete back then and said she needs constant approval, and Kim always looks to her to see what to do next. She says she doesn't want to make any decisions by herself.
Why can we have to be really aggressive? Quick punch, arms. Arms.
I tell you, starting off on balance beam, very, very mentally difficult, but she was one of the toughest mental athletes.
Tim, we used to always sit back and just put our pens down because we knew Kim Zanesco would always hit.
I asked her, what do you think before beam? She said, it's like a showdown. I don't let the beam do anything. I put my feet where I want to put them.
One, and strong legs. Strong, strong, round.
She's, we mentioned the two different gyms that she used to train with prior to going to Cincinnati. Marta Caroli, Peggy Liddick have been two of her beam coaches in the past. And of course, today she's with Mary Lee Tracy.
Right off the bat, she has a huge element right here. This is a back with a full.
That's Mary Lee in the background.
Come on, nail it.
Yeah, she used to do that trick in combination, and it was too inconsistent. She found that this was a much better skill for her.
Come on, Jenny. Come on, you can do it. God, please help. Over the top, hip down. Over the top, and stand up. You can do this, Jenny. Hold your leg up, and then stand up. Okay, stand up. Good job, Jenny.
Always wondering if this commentary from Mary Lee is for Jenny or for Mary Lee.
hold, and work.
It's a great exercise.
Working for. Knees up and finish. Clean. Come on, Jenny, bring it home. You can do it. Come on, Jenny. Good stand up. Find the landing. Get it. Get it. Best event. She was the gold medalist at the Goodwill Games. A lot of difficulty in this routine, and in fact, it starts from a 10.0. She has a combination coming up that gives her 6/10 in 3 moves. Here it goes. Those 3 skills, 6/10 right there.
You see her coach, Donna Strauss, moving the board there. Donna tells me that Kristen is no problem with the 9.4, 9.5 routines, but sometimes is a little bit tight, doesn't let it all go. They have a little thing they are looking for, the queen-like performances on beat. When she does that, she says, we're not talking 9.4s or 5s, we're talking 9.7s and 9.8s.
Is not for this game routine. It's for floor exercise and another gymnast. There are 4 events in the 4 rotations that are being competed simultaneously. Hopefully, and Tim, by the way, are talking about start value. It's a combination of skills that tell you what the maximum score you can get is if you're perfect at everything you're attempting.
That's a great start.
Status of her mental state.
Probably a good thing that she gets right back on.
She won, actually, in yesterday's competition, scoring a 9.8. Her goal in the American Cup was to get 9.8s across the board.
If she's not aggressive here, this will not be good. Very, very difficult flip-flop to lay out.
You're seeing here on the balance beam, she is aggressive.
You're
she
right.
is so sure of herself.
Tough.
It is amazing. 2 different athletes when you watch her on the balance beam versus the uneven bars.
And the beam is probably the most difficult event for 99% of the people, gymnasts in the world. She's just so confident on 3 events, and she lets that fear, that doubts crap its way in on the uneven bars. Not here, though. This is an awesome routine.
Wow.
New mount for her.
Actually, a brand new routine. She's really changed the look of this routine totally. She gets a lot of points through combination skills.
Caught him.
As Elfie said, much of balance beam is all about combining
Calma.
Elements together, both acrobatic and leaps and jumps.
Combinations such as that will give her some bonus skills. She really takes advantage of the quota points that way, Tim. Tough jump. That's called a wolf jump.
Okay.
Full turn.
score. She shows it right here. Double layout.
Thank you.
And these are how I got the results that I got. I didn't count any falls. That's why my team total score is so high. Definitely in that quad, people was counting multiple falls or multiple events. In 1997, the Romanians won with a team total score of a 153.720. In 99, the Romanians won with a 153.527. So with this team final score, take two falls out. I think that's a really. I also think it's fun, would have been fun if there was a world championships in that year, because clearly in that quad, 1998 was Team USA's strongest year. I know some of the scores may be inflated, and I know some of y'all are like, why would Kim Zmesko be on this team? And for 1998, it's just one event. It's vault. She had a Yurchenko 1.5, and very few American girls had a vault worth a 9.8. That's the only event where she's counting her score. I'm thinking Vanessa, Kristen, and Dominique Muciano will have moved on to the all-around. And that quad, three girls made it to the all-around. I'm expecting Dominique Muciano and Vanessa Adler to make it to vault finals. I expect Elise Ray to be the only girl to make burst finals. I expect Beam to be Vanessa Adler and Dominique Muciano. Yes, I know Krista Maloney just won the Goodwill Games on Beam, but I think Vanessa and Dominique were stronger. I expect the girls to make floor finals to be Kristen and Vanessa Adler. I think this would have been a strong team. Now let's take a point off for two falls, because that seemed to be what everybody was counting. They would have scored a 153.037. I think that would have been good enough for second place. I think that would have been fair. I think where Russia was at in 1998, I think where other teams was at in 1998, I think the Americans was the second best team in 1998. And thank you all for diving into the realm of What If with me. I will see you guys in the next episode of... Michaela, Janessa.